Dial MTV was sponsored today by Snickers.
Kenny wasn't like the other kids.
Remote control. TV mattered, nothing else did.
Remote control. Girl said yes, but he said
no.
Remote control.
Now he's got his own game show.
Remote control.
And now it's his basement, his rules, his game show. The Quizmaster 72 Whoopi Coplane, Ken Ober, boy!
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Of course, Colin, Alicia, and Steve over here. Man over here. We got contestants. Yeah, we got contestants. Contestant number one, his name is Harry. Now, Harry is from Long Island, he's a student. Chair, Rachel. Rachel's also a student. She lives in New York City, New York, New York. The city's so nice that it has like five zip codes. And on the end in the blue chair is Mark. Mark's from Burnsville, New Jersey, home of Mike Tyson. Mark works in a record store when he's not sitting in a blue chair. Wish him good luck. Okay, basically this is what happens. We have a giant pyramid up here. If you guess all the things right, you win $100,000. You're not even listening, are you? No, it is the big zenith. Nine channels, questions, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. At the end of the rainbow, hopefully there are prizes of which you have to pay an exorbitant excise tax, but you worry about that when you cross that bridge. Anyway, in control is Harry. Harry, go ahead.
All right, we're gonna go to channel number four, first of all.
Channel number four, MTV. Five points. What kind of outfit is this guy wearing on his new album cover? Mark.
Nothing.
Nothing, right. He's naked.
Woo!
That, of course, Prince, ex-band leader of Sly and the Family Stone. Right? Okay, go ahead, Mark. Mark?
Take channel 9, Ken.
Okay, channel 9, Saturday Night Live. Woo! 5 points. Name the not ready for primetime player who ditched the show and moved on to bigger and better things like Oh Heavenly Dog, The Three Amigos. Okay, Rachel.
Chevy Chase.
Right, and Caddyshack too. Chevy Chase, 5 points. Colin. Colin.
Yes, Ken.
Colin, what are you doing?
Drawing pictures.
Of what?
Pictures.
Of what? Are you sketching?
Not in particular.
You sketching? You sketching, huh?
I'm sketching.
You haven't done that since you were in Austining.
No.
So you've got the skill back. Go ahead, Rach.
Stick with channel 9.
You don't even know what that means. Because I don't know. Saturday Night Live, 10 points. In 1984, you look marvelous became an annoying catchphrase. Mark.
Billy Crystal.
Oh, no. Rachel.
Fernando.
Right. Give me the character who starred the whole thing. Fernando, 10 points. They clapped for that. Go ahead.
I'll go to channel 1.
Channel 1, Elvis. 5 points. Elvis desperately wanted to star in the James Dean story, but who starred in the documentary in Rachel?
James Dean.
Yes, James Dean starred in the documentary. 5 points. Rachel?
I'll go to channel number 3.
Okay, you said the first one. Ready Physics. It's more than science, it's fun. 5 points. Bobby falls in with a bad crowd and goes cow tipping. Now, does a cow have the most kinetic energy before, during, Mark?
During.
Right, or after it's tipped, during. Very good.
Stay with Brady Physics, Ken.
I guess coming from rural New Jersey, you'd know a lot about cows and tipping, right? You gotta give that cow at least 20%, am I right?
Wow.
Oh, not bad.
That's a good one.
Oh, come on! When you get it, when you're on that little bus on the way home, you'll get it, and then you'll go, why, that sly dog? Okay, go ahead, Mark.
Stay with Brady Physics.
Okay, 10 points this time. Little Cindy holds her nose while sneezing, and her head explodes. If half her head flies in a northwesterly direction, in what direction does the other half travel? Rachel.
South?
No. Harry.
Southeast.
Right, southeast. Good. That is the conservation of momentum, or the angular momentum theory, and the reason you should not hold your nose when you sneeze. Harry, go ahead.
Right, we're going to change that channel, man. Let's go to channel number 7.
Okay, channel 7. Toupee or not toupee? The channel which finally dares to answer the age-old question, is that a toupee or just a really bad do? What'd you guys get up on the wrong side of the futon today? What's eating? Okay, here we go. Toupee or not toupee? 5 points. Tom Selleck.
Not
Mark.
Toupee.
Right, Mark. It is
Woo!
Not toupee. 5 points. Go ahead, Mark.
Let's stay with toupee.
Okay, or not toupee. Mensois. 10 points. Frank Sinatra. Mark.
Not toupee.
No. Rachel.
Toupee.
Yes. 10 points. A guy from Jersey doesn't know if Frank's wearing a toupe? Come on. What's going on? Go ahead, Rachel.
I'll go to channel 8. Oh, sorry.
You're dinging
channel
all over the place, Rachel. Channel 8.
Yeah!
Fairy Pixie Corner. Mother Goose fired him. We hired him. He's from Remote Control's own Sheldon Mifkin. Shelly, baby. You're limping a little. What's wrong?
Well, they replaced my hip socket with an elbow joint.
I hate when that happens. Hey, name the actress that this rhyme is about.
I am the fairy pixie. Hark, come listen to my tale. A lumpy blonde pumpkin sat on a wall. The dumpy blonde frumped and had a great fall. When doctors found her, they were really shocked. They asked, how is it like working with Michael J. Fox?
Rachel.
Mallory, who plays Justin Bateman.
No. Harry.
Tina Yothers.
Yes, Tina Yothers, 10 points. See, of course, Rachel, in a communist country, you'd be allowed to blurt out 8 or 9 questions answered. But here in America, you can only say one. Harry?
Let's stick with the fairy pixie.
Okay. You got another one there, Shelley?
Yeah, I am the fairy pixie. Hark, come listen to my tale. As you go around the dial, Rusty always has a smile. What does he know the home viewers can't? Under his robe, Wapner's not wearing pants.
Okay, Mark.
People's Court.
Is that the right answer, Shell? Yeah, People's Court. 15 points. Look at this. Excuse me for a minute. It's my mother. Yama?
You come upstairs and help me pluck the hairs out of my ears.
Pluck, did you say?
Yeah.
Pluck? Oh, pluck. I can hardly understand you with that Canadian accent. My mother's from Montreal. Anyway. Snack break time, and while you guys are snacking away, let's check out the score. Mark and Rachel, 30 points each. Harry's got 20, very close game. We're gonna come back, play round 2, and the person left standing takes home this stuff.
From Chinon, the Auto GX Telecompact 35mm motorized camera with built-in wide-angle telephoto lens. You'll always capture all the action from Chinon.
It's a collection of Columbia CDs with the latest hits from such artists as George Michael and the Bangles.
Bushnell Science Series Telescope, educational product and self-teaching illustrated manuals. Explore the universe from cells to stars and discover the mysteries of life from Bushnell.
Suzuki's Omnicord, the new electronic guitar, lets you be a maestro in minutes the very first time you try. Omnicord, the one man you can strum.
When remote control continues.
Learn what the Russians are really like.
Discovered whether Americans are all that different.
Find out what they listen to.
Make new friends.
I want to check out Motley Crue.
Check out a Gorky Park game.
We want to see Bon Jovi.
Grow and make history while you're at it.
Win MTV's Russian Exchange Contest. Russia is opening its doors to Bon Jovi, Motley Crue, and other major bands joining host Gorky Park for the Moscow Music Peace Festival, the first of its kind ever held at Moscow's Lenin Stadium. 2 solid days of rock and roll, and the only way for you to see it live in person is with us. 3 three MTV winners and their friends will fly to Russia on the Magic Bus with all the bands. And that's not all. Three Russian winners will join you in September at MTV's Video Music Awards.
Glasnost, guitars, and you.
You.
Glasnost begins with a phone call. Call 1-900-328-2000 anytime from now until July 17th. And three random winners will be on their way to Moscow.
P-P-P-P-P-Spectacular.
Cool music.
Not cold war.
This special concert is a charity event for the Make a Difference Foundation.
Do it. After all, everybody speaks guitar.
This MTV contest is sponsored by LA Gear and Levi's.
This edition of Remote Control is brought to you by Steak'em.
Nathaniel Harrison and his brother were separated at birth. Nathaniel was raised in a stately manner. His brother, in a more casual manner. Nathaniel learned to appreciate the finer foods. His brother ate what he wanted. Today, Nathaniel drives a family car and earns $180,000 a year. His brother plays guitar and makes about $18 million. Some food for thought from Steak'em. Food for fun.
This morning, some women will leave for work looking like they've just stepped out of a salon.
Salon to Selective.
Salon Glow.
Salon Selective.
Salon Selectives from the salon experts at Helene Curtis. Four salon shampoos, four salon conditioners. Select your special combination for salon beautiful hair.
Salon Shine.
Feel salon beautiful every day.
Salon.
Hey, thanks for your help, Fred.
Oh, no problem, Tom. Let's see. Noisy dishwasher. And it's probably the water inlet valve.
When unexpected problems occur around the house, be prepared with the Fix-It-Yourself series from Time Life Books. With its easy-to-follow drawings and step-by-step instructions, Fix-It-Yourself is the best way to make sure the job gets done right the first time.
There, that's got it.
Hey, that wasn't too tough. Maybe I should get some of these books.
Examine your first book, Major Appliances, free for 15 days. About every other month, you'll receive another book on the same trial basis.
Take a look at that ceiling fan.
It's okay to me.
Sure, I fixed it myself.
You did?
Mm-hmm. With a little help.
Call 1-800-451-1223 to examine Major Appliances free for 15 days. Keep it and pay only $12.99 plus shipping and handling and get a free ratchet set. You'll receive other volumes one about every other month. Keep only those you want. Cancel anytime. Call 1-800-451-1223.
Hey, buddy. Welcome back to the only game show that removes unsightly warts. Remote Control.
Thank you, Colin. Well, that was certainly an exciting first round, if I might add my editorial opinion. Round two, pretty much exactly the same. The only difference, I'll be talking like Walter Cronkite the entire time. The only difference, the points are double. Gotta watch out for off the air. That's basically it. Running by those scores. Mark, 30. Rachel, 30. Harry, 20. Very good round, all of you. Mark, you're in control.
I can go channel 6.
I'll be. Channel 6. 6 feet under. Once these stars are on top of the world, now they're
6 feet under.
It's like the new Mickey Mouse Club. 10 points. Which TV star died first? John Belushi, Freddie Prinze, or Mr. Ed?
Mr. Mark. Ed.
No. Harry.
Freddie Prinze.
You're right. Freddie Prinze, January 29th, 1977. Mr. Ed died in 79, and Belushi died in 82. Okay, go ahead, Harry.
Yeah, let's stick with 6 feet under.
Okay. Just think, look at the scores. If the sun was to supernova right now and the entire Earth was to go dark and dank and we all died, no one would lose. But what are the chances of that happening? You know, I swear, if I had a piece of meat stuck in my teeth and I could spit that far. Harry. And friends, 20 points, 6 feet under. In the late 50s, his career really flew. Too bad his airplane didn't. Name the guy who sang, that'll be Harry.
Buddy Holly.
Right, that'll be the day. Right, points. Harry, you're on the lead. Colin, let me know when you're done with your sketch.
I'm done.
Can we see, can we get a, anywhere we can get a shot of the sketch?
Yeah.
It's a little sketch of the contestants. Isn't that nice? Okay, very nice, Colin. You are certainly, that part of your brain that, you know, handles the artistic side is swollen, apparently. Go ahead, Harry.
Let's close out the channel.
Okay, 30 points now, 6 feet under. TV's original Man of Steel was played by what very destructible earthling? Harry.
George Reeves.
Right, George Reeves. He died June 16th, 1959. And if my memory serves me well, he, I believe, committed suicide. Am I right? Didn't George Reeves commit suicide?
Steve Reeves.
He did. Thanks. Guy's on a 24-hour general suicide watch over there, just kind of watching everyone. Go ahead, Harry.
Let's go to Channel 4, okay?
Channel 4, Cosby. Yay! 10 points. Poor Rudy. She wanted to play the cymbals in the school band, but got stuck playing
Vanessa.
Mark.
Claire?
No, she got stuck playing Vanessa. Mark, you have no idea how funny that was. Rachel?
She played the clarinet.
No, here's the rest of the question. Oh, but apparently Harry doesn't need it. Go ahead.
Sandra.
No, she got stuck playing, why am I even bothering? Got stuck, I'll read it to the wall. Got stuck playing what boring instrument made by Stradivarius?
Violin.
Violin, right. Violin, see? Now, why did you clap? Well, I don't get it. I just don't get it. Go ahead, Harry.
Let's stick with Cosby.
Okay, 20 points. Name the college that Cliff, Claire, and Russell Huxtable graduated.
Hillman.
Right, Rachel. Hillman College, 20 points. Catch it up to Harry. Go ahead, Rach.
Channel number 6.
Channel 6. Oh, I'm sorry, that's closed.
Channel 7.
Channel 7. Odd Couple. 10 points. Who got married in the last ever episode of The Odd Couple?
Felix.
Mark. More information.
Felix Underwood.
No.
Felix and his first wife.
Name, please.
Gloria?
Yes. Felix and Gloria, 10 points. Name, please. I felt like a Wink Martindale. Go ahead, Harry.
Let's leave it on The Odd Couple for a
while.
Okay,
20 points. What section of the newspaper did Oscar use to find his apartment, Mark?
Classified.
No. What section of the newspaper? Nobody knows. Obituaries. It's not a bad... Actually, a lot of people actually do that, myself included. Go ahead, Harry.
Let's close it out.
Okay. 30 points. Odd Couple. Felix had two kids. Name them both. Did you see a tumbleweed? Was that a tumbleweed? Edna and Leonard. Go ahead, Harry. I can't believe you didn't know that. Go ahead, Harry.
Let's go to Channel 9.
Channel 9, Geek TV. Wimps, worms, nerds, turds, they're all here. Geek TV. 10 points. Name the white-haired geek that Darren Stevens slaved for on Geek. Rachel.
Mr. Stevens?
No. Mark.
Larry Tate.
Larry Tate, 10 points. Go ahead, Mark.
Stay with Geek TV, Ken.
Okay, staying with Geek TV, this is 20 points worth. Governor Gene Gatling couldn't legislate his way out of a paper bag, but fortunately, Mark?
Arizona?
Harry?
Benson?
Yes, but fortunately, he's much smarter. Assistant helped him out. Name the spinoff. Whoa! Harry read my mind. Either that or you can see through the back of the cards.
Oh, a little that. Both.
Okay, Harry, go ahead.
Let's close out Geek TV.
You have a huge lead there, Harry. I don't know if you knew that. 30 points. On the Wonder Years, what's the name of Kevin's mega dweeb best friend?
Paul.
Yes, Mark. 30 points. Wow, he said with mock excitement. Go ahead, Mark.
All right, let's go to Channel 3.
Channel 3, reruns. Name the only TV sitcom in history to be branded offensive by both American Jews and American Nazis. Rachel.
Hogan's Heroes?
Yes, 10 points. Very good. You don't want to piss off the Nazis. Go ahead.
Channel number 1.
Channel 1, Sing Along with Colin. Yeah! 20 points now. Sing the next line from this classic Drifters hit.
Oh, when the sun beats down and they saw up on the roof. And your shoes get so hot, you wish your tired feet were fireproof. Another boardwalk down by the sea.
Mark.
On a blanket with my baby, that's where I'll be.
Okay, 20 points. Yeah! All right. Moves you into second place, Mark. It's either a German air raid or Rachel's going through the wall. I think Rachel's going through the wall. Rachel, awfully nice. Put your buzzer and your thing down. Kiss us goodbye. This is it's do or die time. It's time to play Think Real Fast. 30 seconds, 10 points each. Today, it's time to play Prophet, Reindeer, or Dwarf. I'll name someone from the Bible, say Prophet. And if I name one of Rudolph's buddies, say Reindeer. If I name one of Snow White's little friends, say Dwarf. For example, if I said Doc, you would say Dwarf. So if I say someone from the Bible, you just say Prophet. One of Santa's reindeer, Rudolph's buddies. This is going on much too long. I think you know what I'm talking about. Give me a clock. I think you know how this will work. Let's go. Blitzen.
Mark.
No, he's not a dwarf.
Reindeer.
Yes, Harry. Elijah.
Prophet.
Mark. Yes, Mark. Dopey.
Dwarf.
Yes, Mark. Donner. Mark.
Reindeer.
Yes. Sneezy.
Dwarf.
Mark. Yes. Jonah.
Prophet.
Mark. Yes. Comet.
Reindeer.
Yes. Mohammed.
Prophet.
Mark. Grumpy.
Mark. Dwarf.
Yes. Sleepy.
Mark. Dwarf.
Yes. Prancer.
Reindeer.
Right, Mark. That's it. Oh. I don't know what you're doing to the buzzer, Mark, but you were doing it. Mark, 180. Harry. Mark, you're headed toward the grand prize round where you're going to take a stab at all this stuff.
Get big performance from a small package with Zenith's remote control 9-inch color TV. Perfect for the kitchen or bedroom. This Zenith features an earphone and 178 channel tuning.
SSI Surround Sound System 1000 lets you experience original motion picture sound off videotapes and discs in your home, as if you were in the theater.
From Casio, the MS420 CRA stereo rack system features AM, FM radio, FM stereo, double cassette, semi-automatic turntable, and vertical CD player. If it's high-tech, it's Casio.
Super Snark, one of the world's most popular sailboats, combines easy portability with a tough armor-clad hull. It's a winning combination from Snark.
When remote control continues, whee!
Got to find a host for this show.
No. Yahoo Sirius.
Yeah, the star of Young Einstein.
What is he, some kind of genius?
No, it says here that he's stupid.
Stupid enough to work for $2 a day?
Ha! Nobody's that stupid.
$2 a day? Wow!
At least I could have landed the plane.
Business or pleasure?
Pleasure, please.
Nationality?
Australian.
Name?
Yahoo.
Yahoo? You can't be serious.
That's right, Yahoo Sirius.
Yahoo Sirius, the special host of MTV's big, serious primetime show.
Hi, I'd like 2,000 of these Honey, I Shrunk the Kids cups. See, I'm on the cup because I'm in the movie. Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, it's great. It's from Disney, and it's playing now at a theater near you. That's why I'm on the cup.
The cups are free when you buy any McDonald's supersized soft drink, like Coca-Cola.
Okay, I'll have 2,000 supersized soft drinks. It's hot out. I'm thirsty.
Well, actually, there are three different cups.
I'm a little partial to the Rick Moranis cup. What do you think? Does it look like me?
Collect all three cups, only at McDonald's.
Do you have a big tray?
There they go again, and now Coca-Cola Classic.
Classic wants you to get us ghosts too. They want you to become a Ghostbuster. They say you could win the Ghostbusters 2 Ectomobile. Just grab an entry form where Coca-Cola Classic is sold. We dare you to send it in. So become a Ghostbuster. See if we care.
Baseball cards really capture the action and drama of the game. They're great collectibles and a fun way for the entire family to enjoy the magic of baseball. As a kid, I had to trade to get all the cards for my favorite teams. Now I buy Topps baseball cards in complete team sets. With each team set, I get this attractive wall display. It protects the cards, yet they're easy to take out to review.
Choose your favorite team and call now. You'll receive all the 1989 Topps baseball cards for your team, including the rookies, for only $12.95 plus $2 shipping. Your money back if not completely satisfied. Order now and get 40 bonus cards, including the complete All-Star set, absolutely free. These are genuine Topps cards with the player's complete Major League record on the back.
Share in the fun of collecting baseball cards.
Not available in stores. Call 1-800-227-7000. Get your team set, the wall display, and free bonus cards. Call 1-800-227-7000.
All right, Mark, you pulled it out in the lightning round. Now you're sitting in the, I can't remember the name of this darn thing. It's a bed that folds in the middle. Anyway, you're looking up at 9 screens, you get 30 seconds. You get all 9 right, you take home the grand prize.
A vacation at Caesars Tahoe along the shores of Lake Tahoe. Oh, elegant accommodations, memorable dining and entertainment, year-round recreation and crystal clear surroundings from Caesars Tahoe.
Caesars Tahoe, Mark. Yikes, huh? Yeah, you got your gambling mojo working. Anyway, here we go. You got 9 screens, 30 seconds. Here's a peek. Okay, on your mark. Get set, go.
Number one, Sting. Number
one
two,
right.
Debbie Gibson.
Two right.
Three, pass.
Pass on three.
Four, pass.
Pass on four.
Five, Cars.
Right, five.
Six, Eurythmics.
Six, right.
Seven, Taylor Dane.
Seven, right.
Eight, Julian Lennon.
Eight, right.
Nine, The Cure.
No.
Pass. Three, Bryan Adams.
No.
Four, Keith Richards.
Yes, four.
Three, Paul Notes.
Yes, three.
Nine,
Oh, no. I feel like a basketball ref at the buzzer. Anthrax. Which, bang your head, baby. You missed Anthrax. But that's great. You've got 8 out of 9. You're taking home a camera, CDs, telescope, an Omnicord, a 9-inch TV.
Woo!
That big. A sound thing, a stereo, and a sailboat. A sailboat. You can sail the Tahoe. That's remote control. Adios.
All contestants receive LA Gear, the number one choice in fashion athletic footwear. Designed for performance in hot colors and exciting styles. They look good under pressure. LA Gear. Take control of your life with Zenith multi-brand remote control. It operates most brands of TVs, VCRs, and cable converters from the company that invented remote control, Zenith. It's the remote control computer software game from high-tech expressions. Losing contestants take home the incredible Franklin Spelling Ace makes spelling fast and fun with 80,000 words from Merriam-Webster. Franklin, world leader in handheld electronic reference products. Promotional considerations provided by Dell. Young men's shirts with a hint of fun and sophistication. Tasteful yet innovative. When customers are so demanding, the response must be Dell. Moonies, the harmless way to express your inner feeling when driving. Available at Spencer Gifts, America's favorite contemporary gift store with over 400 stores coast to coast. Sunny Delight Florida Citrus Punch Brand. Morning, noon, and night. Nothing delights you like Sunny Delight. Now available chilled and frozen.
This edition of Remote Control is brought to you by Steak'em.
Nathaniel Harrison.